Hello guys, long time no see. So after so long I'm going to make my last video for Sunny Pirates. Yes, you hear well, this will be my last video for Sunny Pirates. That doesn't mean I will quit the game, but I will stop playing competitive as I used to. So one of the main reasons I will do this is why I was away more than 2 months from the game, so I lost a lot of dailies, a lot of login rewards, a lot of code, so yeah. I don't think I cannot keep up with it. It is like this game doesn't have anything else to give me, you know, because they have stopped releasing more heroes. And because I do not own every character, that it doesn't mean this game is keeping me for some reason, you know. And I do not have to maximize every single character at maximum state for me to be completing some kind of game. So, because my standards were other things like this, where I'm going to show you today. So, the main reason and why did I choose this video to be the last, it is why from the beginning of the game I set it one goal, you know. One of these goals, because I reached most of the goals, and that was the last one, it is to reach 2000 state at Skypiea. I thought if I do that I will achieve what I wanted, even if they did it right now at 2500. Okay, so I finally did it after some time. It has passed more than 2 weeks now that I did it, but I couldn't find time to make video because I got the job that is full-time and I don't have free time that as I used to. So before I start, I really want to say something about the company that owns those games, that is Funpax, that they really have so poor support. It is one of the problems and the reasons, and basically the main reason that I'm leaving this game. Why I say that, you ask? Because before 2 months, it was the thing that we had to reset or bind our passwords because they lost the partnership with Facebook. I don't know what was the problem, I really don't remember. And they gave us around 1 month to do it ourselves manually. That time I was away from the game because I was moving to a new house. I didn't have any internet connection, so I really wasn't paying any attention to those news. And when I came back, the 1 month that they gave us has passed, and around 2 weeks also. So it was 1 month and 2 weeks. So I had to contact the support and to ask them to do it. If you have a specific code, when you log in it appears, they can do it by themselves. So I asked them to do it, and this specific contact we have with them, it took me more than 1 month and a half. So I was away for more than 2 months and a half from the game until this bin happens, okay? Because I had binded my account on my emulator on the PC, but I couldn't play from the mobile. So I was playing until 1 point from the PC only, but I couldn't be on the PC when I didn't have internet connection. So I lost more than 2.5 months, as I told you, and a lot of the game progress. But that wasn't my problem, you know. Even when I get back to see what kind of rewards I lost and stuff, I see the rewards are getting, you know, the rewards and the events I missed were something like pieces of useless characters. That has no use after so long the game exists, like Whitebeard, Sanji, Mihawk, and heroes like that. So I didn't miss any good characters, so I really didn't care about it. Anyway, The main reason why we are here, and I really do not want to say anything more about the support of this game, it is I'm here to show you and give you the absolute team for you to reach up to 2000 stage at Kaipia. Yeah, I finally found the absolute team and treasures, and I did this with this team that I'm going to show you today, and you will be able to gain a lot of amount of goals. So before I show you the team, I'm going to show you one picture that was in the last video that I did, that was back in the 1st of October, as you will see, that I was at 1100 something state that I couldn't pass with any team that I was using, okay? And I left it there. I started building my teams. I was trying to build up my teams up to red state and whatever it needed to upgrade it, and I couldn't do it. So that team that we are going to see today, it is the team that will give you the best advantage to advance from 1000 states of Skypiea up to 2000 with nothing, you know, with one, two tries of every stage, you can pass everything with this specific team. So if you want to see what kind of teams I used to reach up to 1100 and something, you can see all of my progress in Shiny Pirate list that I have. You will find also down below in the description that I have many videos and guides and progress and how I upgraded and how I pick my characters and stuff like that. So you can find anything and many videos of Sunny Pirates if you are a new character. So I have nothing else to tell you. So this is the image, as I told you. That was from the last time I was into the game, and it is before the support being my game. And after that, I joined the game and I didn't make any progress, you know. I wasn't make the dailies. I didn't make any upgrades. I think this is, you know, I just joined into the emulator again after so long. So this is the progress that I will stop right now. Okay. The main characters that we are going to use is Sengoku, Law, Kuzan, Luffy Taro, and Black Arm Zephyr. As you will see, Luffy Taro and Black Arm Zephyr, they are in the first state of the purple state of purple upgrade, and I did it and only because they are 3 and 4 star. I lost a lot of pieces during the login period because I think it's been 2 weeks now that yeah, they upgraded again the daily login bonus. Look at how amazing rewards they are giving now. Back in my days, they weren't giving anything, you know, and now they are giving Black Arm Zephyr for free. Anyway, this is the best period for you to start if you like it, because yeah, now that they are not releasing any other characters, they are giving those characters for free. We spent a lot of diamonds to get those characters in the progress that I have right now, so yeah, it is really hard for you to do it, believe me. So Black Arm Zephyr is one of the characters that you really need. It's one of the main characters, and I'm going to tell you why. And Luffy Taro is the other character that you really need him. One of the main okay, it was a lucky take. So one of the main things and contents where you are able to get him is this one over here, the King's Roulette. So if you join every single day for the Christmas, where is it? Yeah, you will be able to get some King's Lottery tickets from all of the days or most of the days, okay? And then the other The other place where you are able to get it is from here, but this is so hard to take it, so yeah. Eventually they're going to add it, add them over here also, but yeah, I don't think this will be, you know, in some months. They're giving all of the Luffy's except Luffy Taro. Anyway, so the team that, as you see over here, I am up to 2002. I cannot pass this one because it really needs the newest characters, the two newest characters. Maybe also Flame Emperor, I don't know, maybe, I'm not sure. So it needs for sure Monkey D. Dragon and Kaido. Because a lot of characters ignore dodge and yeah, Sengoku doesn't help a lot in these stages. So this is the team that we are going to use, and I'm going to explain to you what kind of use everyone has. The three main characters that you really need are Sengoku at full state, believe me, it really helps. Low at full state also, because he really needs to have that extra points of stats, because of he really needs to survive until one point in some specific stages. Next is Kuzan, not the Glacier Kuzan, this specific Kuzan, the old one. Next it is Luffy Taro, he is the main dealer, and after that he is the Black Arm Zephyr, but he is the main dealer, guys. So next we need three specific warships. As you see over here, those are the tires that I have them. You don't need to go further. If you want to go further, it is fine. If you have them further, it is fine, but this is at which point I did it. So you need tire six, this ship that gives you dodge, at tire 8 at this ship that gives you attack speed, and the last one that is really plays a crucial role in this one, this the Boa Hancock ship. You don't have to level it up, only one level, okay? I'm going to tell you every ship what it does, so you understand what exactly why you need it, okay? So the first one, as I told you, it is the Sand Pirate ship that gives you 80% attack speed. So the help of attack speed means that you're going to hit faster. Some characters also have attack speed, but with this specific help, it will help you more. Okay. Next, we need the Thousand Sun, because it gives us extra 50% chance to dodge all attacks. With additional of Sengoku, this means a lot of dodge in our team and in the first steps of deflecting most of the attacks, okay? And as for the last, it is one of the latest ships that they added into the game, the Perfume Yuda. This is Boa's ship, restoring a certain percentage of HP of the teammates and resisting all restraints such as stun, charm, silence, petrification and things like that, okay? The resisting of restraints such as stun, charm and silence really helps you, because nothing stops your characters to hit and use their skills, because most of their characters, like Sengoku, if they do not use their skill of absorbing and reflecting, our team is going to die from the beginning, okay? So there is no point for having Sengoku if he's going to be stunned from the beginning. You have to retry again, and for him to use this one, the Marine Fling Admiral, that gives 100% chance to dodge all attacks. So from the beginning, as he used this skill, nothing can hit your teammates. For I don't know for how much time it is, for some seconds, but anyway, you understand what I mean. Also, with this one that increases his own ability up to 150%, this will last longer, and also the dodge will increase. So that is why Sengoku is must-have character into the team. Okay, for his treasures, I used those over here and at this specific state. I'm using skill leads because he does have a lot of AoE skills that deal a lot of damage to all the team. So he's getting a lot of HP back. And because of his AoE skills, he's able to destroy at least some energy that prevent the enemies from restoring energy fast and also use their ultimate skills. And the pink pirate hat, if someone hit him, at least to give some reflect back. It is not 100% that you need all of those three, but this is what I used to. So for the next one, we have Law. Law is also a key role character because until the dodge and the reflect that Sengoku give to our team, Law is keeping the team alive. Because Law is increasing and decreasing at the same time, our enemy and the enemy team, sorry, our team and the enemy team at the same time 50% of attack. As you see over here with the room, okay. Next, he's able to deal damage equal to 60% of max HP to one specific target. So if he's going to hit a key role character from the enemy team, he's going to one-shot one of the characters. So it is really a good skill if this works well. Next, he really restores energy so fast. He will work really nice with treasures that restore energy, or he does have a slow energy of anyway, any treasure with energy will work really well. And this is the healing effect of our team. You know, he's dealing damage and also restoring HP to all allies. Okay, so he's really amazing support and damage dealer. That I really suggest you to enable him into your team. I do not have specific things into him because I used some other treasures to other characters that I really wanted. So I left him with two slow rates. So whenever he does the bubble, he slows them by 16%. So yeah, for me it is right. All right. And I have 4% to repel them. So yeah, it didn't work every single time, but I didn't have anything else to give him. So yeah, those are the gems that I have for him. Most of those are level 5, one level 6, and one level 7 because he works the best with his HP. So I played him only one HP and some defense, you know, for him not to die so easily. Let me show you also Sengoku because I didn't show you. Here we are. Those are the gems that I have for Sengoku. And next we are moving to Kuzan. So Kuzan is also one of the key role characters that also you need. Okay, because not only he freezes all of the enemies, and the freeze hit rate increases with skill level, so he works at the best of at 100 level, you know, but increase 50% receive of attack they will gain, you know, when he put the freeze down. He plays a debuff on the enemy team that they're going to get 50% more damage. That is quite nice for your team. Next, he's also a big damage dealer for AoE damage, and also reduce 90% of attack speed of the enemy. So whenever someone being caught on this ice, he's hitting so slow that you will be able to kill at least one or two characters in a round. So yeah. Next, he's able to immobilize one of the characters. It has lower, you know, low rate to hit, but if this succeed, you are able to get one character out. So with Law and after Kuzan, you are able to get at least two characters out only with those two characters. And as for the last, he does have a lot of attack speed, so this make it easier for him to restore energy and spam his skills over and over. Okay, you're going to see it also I'm going to do some stages. Next, we have the two most, crucial characters that we need. The first one, it is Black Arm Zephyr. I'm going to do the Lufitaro at last. So I used and upgrade them up to purple state because they are the lowest star characters that I have. So I wanted them to have the more stat as they as they could get, because they are front type characters and they are getting the most of the damage. So Black Arm Zephyr, I did already a video for most of those characters, but I'm going to tell you again. He's dealing damage equal to HP and ignores the dodge of the enemies. So whatever the enemy has, if they have Sengoku or if they have Katakuri, because Katakuri has a lot of dodge, he's going to hit him, whatever the dodge. Okay, he's ignoring the dodge. So damage equal to max HP and that ignoring the dodge is one of a kind, you know. So he's a must-have character for this specific reason. Next, we have this. Basically, all of his skills dealing damage equal to max HP, and most of his skills are ignoring the dodge of the team. So even if the enemy trying to cover their, you know, characters with dodge, he will deal damage no matter what. So yeah, he's one must-have character. Look at this. Ignores dodge damage to a certain percent of max HP. Destroying enemy shield buff. So also he's destroying the buffs and the shield specific from the enemies, and dealing also damage equal to max HP. So a character that is 100 level is he's in his maximum state and he has a lot of HP. So look at this. For an example, he has more than 200,000 HP. That is a lot of HP, guys. And believe me, if he's getting, if he's spamming those skills, yeah. And the other good thing, because he's front character, as I told you, every time Z loses 10% of his max HP, he will restore 5% of his max HP to two random allies. So he's also restoring HP. He's also a support, and from all that, he's resurrecting. After he dies, he's resurrecting back. So you have someone that spams and restores HP to two of your allies. And look at this. Skill cannot be used to resurrect. Skill can be used to resurrect once, and consuming all the stored energy to increase the max HP after resurrection. So this guy is amazing. I don't know how they did it, but they made the, you know, if you make this specific character, I think at 5 Sans, I don't think you maybe need also Lufitaro, but those two together are amazing duo. And as for the last, and the also the same reason, I upgraded Lufitaro because he's 3 star character. He miss a lot of his stats at maximum state. If he was 5 suns, sorry, I could probably progress further and maybe to reach 2500 state. But I'm not going to do it, because it is not so easy to get Lufitaro up to this state. You know, it needs a lot of pieces. Yeah, and I really do not have the patience to do it. So Lufitaro has the same unique skill to revive himself, and also not only revive himself, but increase and dodge all attacks and be in this specific Snake Man state, and hit multiple of the enemies and to do a lot of stuff. But not all of this matters if you do not have a specific thing that they released lately into the game. This is one of the latest, sorry, I didn't show you the items of Black Arm Zephyr and the gems. So I used save energy because I really wanted him to save as much energy to hit all the time with his max HP and dodge attacks, and he's dealing a lot of damage. You are going to see it also. And I didn't have anything else to show, to add it over here, so I put a reflect damage also. His gems are over here. I put mostly on this one on attack. The rest are level 6. As you see over here, I just changed it, so you didn't need anything else. For Lufitaro, I put everything I had because he really need everything you could do. If you can maximize him, do it, guys. He definitely worth it. He's one of the best characters into the game right now. He's one of the best attackers into the game right now, the best dealer into the game. And one of the main reasons and the main treasures that you really need is those two artifacts. Or treasures, as you can call them. So I put one save energy because I really needed him to restore, and with the help of my team, I restore so fast the energy. And the damage that he's getting from the beginning of the fight, he's restoring so fast energy. But you needed two more things to really add him some dodge rate ignorance. So he's hitting so fast and so hard, but he cannot hit them because they have dodge. So I put those two items that they play really crucial role. You really need those two items to pass every single of those stages, because you are going to face a lot of Sengokus and a lot of Katakuris, and they are going to be pain in the ass, guys. So you really need Doc, Q Apples and Caesar Candy, at least to 1 star. This is going to reduce all dodge rate. So try to use it on him, and with his all attacks, you know, he's going to help you go further and reduce all the dodge that the enemy have. So this is how my team works, okay? So as you see over here, even let me lower this one. As you see over here, even with the team has their own, you know, dodge, I'm able to hit them with the two of those guys, okay? So I'm not able to beat them right now because they are probably OP. They have different kind of treasures that I really don't know, and this team over here is really overpowered. He does have two dodge rate characters over here. The one is the dragon and the other one is Sengoku. So probably I will need Emperor Ace or something, or at least to do something else. Look at this. I tried it different kind of times with different time of teams, and I cannot go further because I'm getting my damage being reflected. Even if I do kill some of those, the rest are killing me. So yeah, it is so hard. But look at this, Lufitaro is killing it, guys. He's killing it. So look at this. I'm going to add Kizaru to increase my attack speed, so I will do it faster, okay? I'm going to increase and spam more of my skills, but nothing. Look at this. This reflect is killing me. It's killing me. Whatever I use, if I use oh my god, I forgot his name. Anyway, he does have a reflect. Even my reflect doesn't work. My pushback, my reflect doesn't work. Nothing works. So I think I really need the newest characters right now to go further. I'm using everything, you know. You need all of those characters. The only characters that you are able to change it is Kuzan. Yeah, you cannot take out any other character, you know. I also tried to use Zoro, that it was one of the crucial up to 1000. Nothing happened, so I tried to use Cracker because I have a lot of attack speed treasures. Nothing happens. I tried to use ETD also because of his silence and the damage, one hit skill that he has. Nothing happens. It is really hard, you know. I think I'm dying from my own damage. Because I have a lot of damage, I'm dying. Let me use also to push them back with my gear for Luffy. Yeah, this dragon is killing me. He's really killing me. So I need to get dragon over here. It is really hard for me to keep up with this one. So that was the team, guys, that I used to go up to here. Look at how much gold did I make. 500 million gold. And you are able to get up to here 35 million each time you raid this specific spot. Okay. I was so happy to do this video because I see a lot of kind of questions how and what is the best team to use up to this stage. So that was the team, guys. I hope I explained every single thing you needed to get and understand what and why you need to use those characters. Do not forget to see and the rest of the videos because you really have to see it to understand how hard it is to upgrade the characters and at least up to purple state. And I really was happy to make all of those videos because it was one of my favorite games, guys. So if you really need to support me from now on, I'm going to support Dragon Ball. This will be the only game because they did the same thing from at the Pocket Leaf Ninja. They are not beating my account even if I'm waiting more than 2 months, guys. It is from the same company, Funpacks, if I am right, and they are not binding my account. I'm still waiting. I cannot understand why they are doing it. It is because I am not spending any money. I don't know, but I really do not care. I'm not going to support them either. So I'm going to keep uploading videos for Dragon Ball Saiyans United because they have a lot of things and a lot of characters to release. But this will be my last video, and if you need the codes that they are releasing, you have to go yourself to the official page and see it every Monday and every week. Okay. I hope to see you again in the next video. Bye.